Good morning, students. Standard 10 Political Science. Working with Constitution. Today, second lecture. Last time we briefed what exactly the work of Constitution in relation to democracy, social justice. We saw that Indian democracy is particularly related to representative form of government. The parliamentary setup of the government is in such a way that people choose their own representative, and while choosing the representative, the constituencies through which the elected members move for parliament or for state assembly are the people who are representing the constituency as legislature. Now, this legislature, we see that is a law making body, or we call it law making body. Because of this law-making body, we come to know that these peoples who are the representatives have the burden of the voters of that constituency, and naturally they try their best. But while working with constitution, we have to understand that the Indian democracy has gone through the phases, and first is political maturity. We saw age of 21 was reduced to age of 20, was reduced to age 18. From 21 to 18, as the age was revised, we come to know that the maturity for the youths is expected to be now from age 18. On the global scenario, in some countries, this age is now expected even up to 16. But as far as India is concerned, we are at the age 18, from where maturity starts. Because of the vast experience of more than 70 years of the constitution, Indian constitution has been reshuffled. It is said to be a living document. Living document because changes can be made, amendments can be made. Last time we saw about the amendments related to election commission and finance commission. But while doing so, here are some rights, and that was one right to vote. Every individual who crosses the age of 18 gets right to. Similarly, in the last few years, we see that right to information was also given from 2005 onwards. After that, we come to know that right to education, which is also the other side of child labor. So to stop the child labor, responsibility was taken by the government. Keep it in mind, all these rights as an individual or as a citizen of India we receive is because with the development, with the time progress, India's financial status grew, and nation leaders or national leaders or the people responsible for the working with the constitutions have parliamentarians, as we call them, have dedicated themselves for the well-being. Now, when we study this, when we try to understand all these things, it tells us that there are both the sides, good as well as bad. And to control all these things or all these things done by the parliamentaries, who are also the members of the executive, that is the president, prime minister, even the cabinet ministers, along with the IAS, IPS, IFS officers, all these are being checked, controlled by legislature. So the execution is under the burden or has to be working with the legislature. When these both are working hand in hand, and if there comes a nexus between the two, that is the legislature and the executive, the third option remains open, that is judicial system. Supreme Court of India, that is an autonomous body, is not under the control of either legislature or executive. But we have to understand, when the law is being made, working with the constitution means when the law is to be made, law made by the legislature can be revised by Supreme Court. Supreme Court has an authority to define the meaning of the law or each and every word of the law. But sometimes there comes a clash between Supreme Court and the executive, Supreme Court and the legislature. At this juncture, when there is a clash between the Supreme Court and the legislature, the legislature has the ability to make law. It's a law-making body. So if legislature, that may be Lok Sabha or Vidhan Sabha,
लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा वी कैन से पार्लियामेंट व्हेन लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा कंबाइनली गिव्स अ स्टेटमेंट और कम्स फॉरवर्ड इन सपोर्ट ऑफ एनी लॉ देन इट इज बाइंडिंग और सुप्रीम कोर्ट मस्ट बी अबाइड टू दैट लॉ. सुप्रीम कोर्ट कैन नॉट डिक्टेट द लॉ. सुप्रीम कोर्ट कैन शो what are the shortcomings. Supreme Court can tell us how the law cannot be implemented or why the law cannot be implemented, but law cannot be made by Supreme Court. Even if some dictates, some judicial verdicts converts into law, and they convert many times it happens, it should be approved by the legislature. And it is here that we must know that Indian Constitution has given the supreme authority the legislature, particularly Lok Sabha, because Lok Sabha is the body of the representatives directly elected by the people of India. The representatives of the people of India who nominate themselves in the Lok Sabha have the authority to make. And the biggest asset in the Lok Sabha is money bill cannot be passed without the consent of Lok Sabha, without the consent of Lok Sabha, or whatever the matters related to finance are, should be first tabled in Lok Sabha. Now, this is where we can understand one side. But while doing so, we also have to understand the social justice. In the name of social justice, because India is a vast country, and in this vast nation, we come to know that there are various sections, there are various groups, ethnic groups, which though belong to Hinduism, are somewhat apart from, in the name of region, in the name of caste, creed, race, even the gender bias, male, female, or male-dominated world, as we always call it. And while doing so, there are certain things given, dictated by the constitution in the name of social justice. First, policy of reservation of seats. Last year in standard 9, you must have studied who are the SC, who are the ST, ND, and all these sections, as we call them, the majority, the minority, and then the differentiation of the religions, differentiation in the name of caste, all these have their own proportion in the name of population or in name of population. And while doing so, policies of reservation since beginning, in the name of the seats to Lok Sabha, to Rajya Sabha, to Vidhan Sabha, to Vidhan Parishad, even at the local self-government, are being nominated or mentioned in the constitution. Then, why moving further, as India comes in contact with many of the problems, day-to-day problems, new laws were enacted. And one major law was Atrocities Prevention Act. Majority cannot dominate minority in any sense which will hurdle, which will disturb the day-to-day life, the respect of any individual minorities or scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, nomadic tribes. So naturally, constitution takes heed, and while doing so, if the legislatures, if the executive are able to carry on it, then judicial system will intervene. And to intervene it, there is Human Rights Commission. At the national level, at the state level, along with it, there is a Minorities Commission, Women Commission. Now, all these are working hand in hand to give self-esteem to every individual of India. Majority definitely, because they are in majority. They will always try to dominate the minorities. But while dominating, it should never be in a sense of a hurdle to any individual Indian. And that is why we call it rights. Rights are the ingredient aspects of every individual Indian. And any Indian can move in the court if his or her rights are being dominated even by the government. So naturally, the rights given to individual are supreme status to every individual. Apart from that, there are certain provisions for minorities. Provisions for minorities are just like the means giving basic framework of the constitution. It is what the provisions are. Minorities, people in minorities are few in number. So they need to protect their language. They need to enhance their language. They want to develop, they want to take care of not only the language, along with them the religious rights, the behavior pattern, the dress code,
and all these are preserved by in the name of constitution, by the government in the name of constitution. For example, there are minority schools, the Muslim school or the Urdu school as we call it, the Gujarati school, the Sikh or Sindhi, and various in the name of language or even in the name of religion. You can find many of the schools which are dedicated to religious activities, and it is the right for the minorities. The constitution has given. Constitution has taken utmost care of every individual, and even if with the changing time some problems arise, then constitution as a living document have that right, have that ability to convert itself, to change itself, and new laws can be enacted. There are many laws which are being amended. मराठीमध्ये घटना दुरुस्ती म्हणतात, कायदा बदलला जाऊ शकतो किंवा कायद्यात बदल करता येतो. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट थिंग, अँड वाय डूइंग सो प्रोविजन्स फॉर द मायनॉरिटीज आर टेकन इन टू कन्सिडरेशन वाय ड्राफ्टिंग एनी रूल्स अँड रेग्युलेशन फॉर एनी लॉ. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दॅट देर इज ऑल्सो लॉज फॉर वुमेन, रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ वुमेन. In last years, that is standard 9, you must have studied regarding the women's representation in the local self-government, state government, national government and many other national bodies. Women and child welfare is a special department working with the central government of India. So also at this state level. Now, it is specifically being designed or dedicated for the upliftment of the women. Why it means so, we have to understand the other side also. And it is in the name of that women since ages, not only in India, throughout the world, are being dominated by the male. Because they are being dominated by the male, or it's a male-dominated society as we call it, the male-dominated society that always try to be superior to the women, constitution has provided certain rules, as we have right to information, as we have right to vote, so also, though not exactly the right, but law has been intervened in many cases in which women have been given their due share, the respect which otherwise was never done. Though they are highly educated, though they are very powerful executors, yet they were being deprived, they were being kept apart. And Maharashtra became the first state in India to give 50% reservation, at least in local self-government. Maharashtra became the first state in India to give 50% reservation seats in the local self. Now, what local self is? Last time we saw that. Whatever that is related to our district, Jilla Parishad, Panchayat Samiti, Nagar Palika, Nagar Panchayat, Mahanagar Palika, Gram Panchayat, all these are the local's third part of local self-government. And in every, now for example, we are in Apollo. Whatever the membership of the Mahanagar Palika of Apollo is, that is the ward members of Apollo is, 50% are women. Now it is because working with the constitution, constitution has given this right to the women. Means we have to choose. There may be a ward in which four women are struggling to be for their victory, one will be victorious, but after the result is being declared, you will find that 50% women are being declared as victorious for ward members. Now, this is how laws are being made. Now, because of this, what we come to know that all the sections of the society, with utmost care, have been given their due share. But sometimes it occurs that it will not work accordingly. So again, there is judicial system. Court intervenes and court takes the decision in favor of those who are being deprived of their due share, of their respect, of their whatever the rights they were given by otherwise by the constitution. It is here that we have to understand that though India also have the majority, and yet minorities are being given their due share because of the court. Not only the Supreme Court, But there are various bodies, as we come to know, that the National Human Rights Commission, the Minorities Commission, the Women's Rights Commission. So are also there many other works carried on. Even as we spoke about the central government of India or even the state governments, that there is Women and Child Welfare Department. Apart from that, Human Development Resource is a special department which works with higher education of India. Many other quality education to be provided to the students, to the youth of India. So special branch is being devised, and all this together work for the betterment of the citizens. While doing so, if the legislature or the executive in the nexus moves hand in hand, and if they deprive someone of one or the other points, then definitely we know that judicial system plays a major role. In India, we come to know that National Human Rights Commission, you must have studied in 8th standard, 9th standard, that there are 7 members for the National Human Rights Commission, and they have the same autonomous status of the Supreme Court judge. Though they are not the judge, though they are not the equivalent, yet status is given, and each and every office of the government have to take heed of the notice of Human Rights Commission. So naturally, it is one. And Human Rights Commission is the concept that came into being after Second World War, 1945. And after that, many countries, including India, accepted it. So in India, we have national as well as state Human Rights Commission. As minorities, you all know that what is the basic concept among the minorities? Minorities are being given the rights to preserve their own identities in the name of either religion, either region, either their language, their daily life, that is the rituals change, and they have been given the rights to celebrate their whatever the festivals that are coming time to time. They also are being given protection by the government so that there will be no harm from the majority to these minorities. Apart from that, we also have to understand the basic framework of the constitution. Basic framework of the constitution is in the name of federal. And federal is three tier system: central, state, and local self. Now, this three tier system, federation, union of all states make federal. So all the states of India and union territories combinedly come together to make central. So the headquarters of the central is Delhi. Headquarters of the state, we are in Maharashtra, so Mumbai. And then as right now we are in Akola, so Akola. Now, while doing so, while trying to understand the federal system, basic framework, we have to understand that all three have the same rights. As here is the Prime Minister, here is the Chief Minister, and here is the Mayor, because Akola is the Mahanagar Palika, here is the Mayor, or even if village, Gram Panchayat, then Sarpanch, they are the head of the constitutions at that level. And all the work that is carried out is in the name of government or in the name of constitution. 73rd and 74th amendment, last time as we saw that, 73rd and 74th amendment brought about a radical change that is responsible for today's India. The Chief Election Commission office was, as it is the autonomous office, was given the charge, and it was made mandatory that elections in anyhow conditions should be only up to 5 years. After 5 years, new government must come. New government in the central, at the state level, even at the local level. So, because of this, certain changes started. Even the finance commission was established. And because of that, the direct relationship with the finance commission brought about a new change, that money that was first percolating is now directly related with the offices to which they are related. Now, because of this, we come to know that the basic framework of the constitution tells us that there is decentralization of power in India.
power is not accumulated in any one hand. Decentralization, that means all the rules and regulations are distributed in such a way that no one can become supreme.
But here is also the other side. No one claims the responsibility.
Now, in politics, it all happens. We are not studying the politics. We are studying about the constitution. But constitution has made a provision in which no one person in India can be the supreme or the supreme. If it occurs, either the legislature or the judicial system will intervene. And judicial system is the only system. Supreme Court is the authorized body, which means now we can't say that dictates, but it explains the word meaning of each and every word of the law. How the law is to be accepted. What is it? In other words, that Supreme Court has the authority to explain to the people or even to the government what is the law, how it should be implemented. That means it keeps a watch on the working of one legislature as well as executive. No law in India can be made only for the majority. But law which is applicable for more than 50% people can be accepted. Now here is also the majority and minority, because more than 50% makes majority. But in the name of any one religion, government cannot support it. And that is why in India, all the communities have been intermingled in each other at national level. Now, this is the basic framework. One, decentralization, and then federal. At the same time, there are some significant judicial decisions. Means whatever we are speaking, that how court intervenes, how court comes into. There are many, since 1950 onwards, there are many decisions which have gone against the government. But time and again, government also accepted the verdict with due respect to the court, and this is why India's democratic system has become very strong. In 1975, Allahabad court gave a verdict against the then Prime Minister of India. After that, as the time changed, slowly there came a major change, and with due respect to certain examples related to women, is women now gets the due share in her father's as well as husband's property. Now, it is not the case that it's a male-dominated society only. Even today, definitely, we call it a male-dominated society, but each and every girl from the house has the same right as it is with the son. So, wife also gets the status of similar, equivalent with her husband. And because of that, slowly the status is changing. We come to know that last year in 9th standard, you must have studied how women at large, in the name of dowry, were being in the means either suicide cases or death cases came into being. And even police was pressurized not to carry on the charges, not to carry on the investigation. But because of the law, because of the constitution, because of the changing trend of rules and regulations, it is now made compulsory, mandatory. And because of that, many laws are there which are in favor of women. Also, to bring them further, with the protected scenario, 50% is at the state level now in local self-government. But this has brought about many changes in the political scenario also, that we see good working efficient women coming forward. At the same time, there are also people's interest litigation is a process by the court in which court directly intervenes, and there are many cases, particularly consumer cases. Jago Grahak Jago is something that court, with due respect, because a consumer is not a united process. And the manufacturers unitedly try their best to manipulate the market. While doing so, frauds goes on. Illegal trafficking or illegal work is carried out. But because the consumers are not so strong against that manufacturer, many times or for since long time, they made the best use of the protected market. Against this, Consumers Protection Act came into being and the judicial system started intervening. It's also a quasi court, but whatever the working it is in favor of common man. Similarly, one example we can give was related to a high profile murder in Delhi. The death of a well-known famous female character that time took place in the club. And after that, the culprit who was caught on charges just as a suspicious was left. At that time, national newspapers carried on with the title, the editorial pages for near about 6-7 days. And the title was Nobody Killed Jessica. Jessica was a character or a woman who was shot in the club. And yet police says that because there was no proof, the suspicions was left. Because of these editorials at the national network newspaper, in English newspaper, court accepted it, reopened the file, and again the case went on, charging the culprit and giving verdict against him. So this is the strength of the fourth pillar, we call it newspapers or electronic media. Now, it is because of the changing scenario of the judicial system. Apart from that, there are many cases, you can get many cases in India where personal level and individual fought against the central government, the state government or the local self-government, any of the government, and person become victorious against the government body. That means the government body is not supreme as far as the laws are concerned in India, and that is the greatest achievement of the constitution. It is here that while working with the constitution, we have to consider certain things, and they are one, responsible government. Government of India at the national level, at the state level or at the local level is responsible. That means if Prime Minister resigns, the whole ministry resigns. If Chief Minister resigns, the whole ministry resigns. Or even if in the name of execution, the working is going on, the cabinet ministers try to work, some of them are more aggressive, and if they start working during the parliamentary session, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, questions are being asked, and these questions, while answering, the minister cannot give his own answers. He has to be pinpoint perfect truth. Truth is being revealed, and that is why the government is responsible to legislature. Indian government is responsible to legislature. State government is also responsible to Vidhan Sabha, Vidhan Parishad, the state level legislature, and so is at the self, local self government. The responsive government, responsible we can understand now, but responsive government must respond, and this response is to the judicial system, directly related to the judicial system. With each and every individual, directly or indirectly, government is responsible. That is also the other side of the people who participates in the daily working of the government. And by doing so, government must respond positively. Respond positively. We many times, because of electronic media nowadays, there is a vast change in giving the news. But we come to know that at the local level or at the state level, national level or at anywhere in India, some incidents happen of which the government takes note. That is responsible. Then people's participation. More and more people actively should participate. Various organizations come forward gathering people, either to protest, to support or whatever the activities they are. But participation of the people must be known. And one more, transparency. How the government works, we don't know. What exactly the whole day the Prime Minister or the Minister do. But when there is a parliamentary session, when there is an assembly session, when there is a coming together of the local self-government bodies, questions are being asked by the opposition and even by the ruling party members, to which the legislature, in the legislature, executive have to answer. So that is transparency. The answers given by the prime minister, ministers, and all the other bodies are in such a way that they cannot neglect the questions asked by either opposition or the ruling party. And that is the biggest transparency that comes in the working of the government. Because of this, people show faith not only in government, but it is the faith in constitution. Hope you understood what exactly working with the constitution is. Thank you.